pasture wagons and many provisions. Horses and ponies had been sent round by security's pass to meet them at their appointed landing place. The master and his councillors bade them farewell from the great steps of the town hall that went down to the lake. People sang on the quays and out of windows. The white walls dipped and splashed, and off they went north up the lake on the last stage of their long journey. But they answered nothing. Sometimes with the bag, and the others after days of violent deaths and its defences soon followed them. The day of the camp was made to the east of the lake, right between the arms of the mountain. The rocks echoed with the voices and the song, there was the sound too of the rocks and of sweet music. And as it echoed up towards them, it seemed to be below, but he could not answer, only hold on and blink. The sun was shining brilliantly, and it was a long while before he could bear it, when here and there, when here and there,
by the breeze, and there were everywhere hundreds of butterflies. I expect they were a kind of purple emperor, a butterfly that loves the tops of oak woods. But these were not purple at all. They were a dark, dark, velvety black, without any markings to be seen. Woo!